Hi guys, we are the street team and we're going to be asking teachers about Zoom.
So far, Zoom has been a challenge, but I think that it's working. I'm lucky that I got my master's in basically in distance education, and so you know it wasn't that much of a stretch for me to learn how to teach online or in through distance learning or distance education. There are some pros and there are some cons. I do miss all of our students. I do miss seeing you guys on a daily basis, being able to have short conversations whenever we want, you know, and just seeing you every day and being part of the school culture in that way. So that is kind of a con. I miss that. But some pros are that, you know, with education, distance education, and technology, you know, we can provide service or education whenever the students are ready. So, you know, that becomes a little bit more valuable during this time because not everybody's schedule is the same. Some people are picking up some extra responsibilities now that we are during this pandemic and the situation. So I believe that is an advantage of distance learning and distance education. Oh yeah, so you know, at the beginning of Zoom, of course, you know, we always have our kidders or our students who, you know, are just more creative than others, right? And like to push and test the boundaries of everything. And so of course we had some Zoom bombers coming in and they were saying some outrageous comments, you know, during a Zoom class. And you know, being new to Zoom, even though, like I said, I got my master's in distance education, I hadn't necessarily used a lot of Zoom. So just trying to find and organize, like, and to see what student is talking at this time to figure out who it was a challenge. And so a couple of very inappropriate comments were being said. And, you know, students were like, "Oh, Mr. Menace, is there a way to block that person?" You know, so students were really nice about it as well. And they understood. So I just took it in stride. And then kind of just changed the way that I let people into my classroom and made sure I took roll right at the door. You know what I'm saying? And so if anybody that I didn't know had a different name, you know, they wouldn't be let in. And then, of course, that seemed to stop. So.
Oh, gosh, that's a loaded question. In our what's going on in the world right now, I think that this is safer. But if it came down to would you rather teach online or teach in person, the truth is there's pros and cons to both. I really, though, because I teach theater and dance, I really like being in the classroom just because all of everything we do is in person and meant to have an audience and meant to have a stage and meant to have like a lot of tools that I don't have this way. There's a community aspect that's missing. So in that respect, I'd rather be there, but I do like the commute to this one because it's literally upstairs to downstairs. And if I have to, you know, go get coffee or do whatever at any time, like it takes 5 minutes. So there's something to be said about being home and being in the comfort of your home. But I also know that all of my normal tools are at school, so I kind of miss that. Well, first you have to make the choice to be engaged, and that's really difficult, but you have to basically come to this like you would go to school and say, this is my classroom and I'm here for this time and I need to be engaged. The second thing is with this type of learning and this type of lifestyle, it's actually very easy for time to get away from you. So scheduling and structuring and making sure you have a calendar is super helpful in keeping track of what you're doing, because otherwise you will just get sidetracked and you'll forget. You will completely forget that you had all these things to do. And it's very easy. All of us adults are having the same issue. And then I would say, honestly, I would say a lot of people need to just sort of let go of a few things, let go of what was, let go of what should be, and just kind of roll with it. Because the thing is the fact that we're fighting it makes it harder. So if you just sort of roll with it and kind of nod and go with it, it makes this whole process just a little easier. And then finally, communication, like communicate with your teachers, communicate with each other. If we're not in the same room, so we don't know what's going on. And if you don't tell us, there's no way that we can help.
Hello everyone, this week's fun fact is that did you know that a group of penguins is called a huddle?
Thank you for joining me for another Lobovision. My name is Isaac Augustine. See you all next week.